Traps come in a lot of different forms in D&D. There's mechanical traps, magical traps, puzzles, all types simple and complex. However, one of the major issues many players face is that traps aren't something they can usually carry around or set themselves. We're going to be looking at a homebrew solution and attempt to solve this problem. Today we're looking at traps in a bottle. These traps are spells taken from the 5e SRD that have AoE effects, such as black tentacles. Instead of the spell being an immediate effect, we instead have its effect bottled as a magical oil. The oil, when applied over a 5-foot surface, creates a magic contact trap that will persist for 24 hours or until triggered. In the example of black tentacles, the effect would trigger when the oil is stepped into, upon which a smaller version of the spell goes off, affecting that 5-foot space. These traps solve a lot of problems for roguish players who want to use the element of surprise more effectively at higher levels. A trap is now something they can carry with them and apply in certain situations to many different effects. There are lots of different ways that you can balance the mechanics for these oil traps. If you're not letting your players craft them, then balance simply relies on availability and cost. In the event that players can make them, cost of components and time required to make a magical item are how you can restrict their use in addition to their availability in traps. For any of these items, we think it's important to limit the use of it. The effect should almost always be slightly less potent than the spell. Concentration spells that are turned into traps lose that requirement, but instead have their duration or area of effect decreased. Going back to our black tentacles example, the area of effect is reduced down to a single 5-foot square instead of its full range. This makes the trap more focused and purposeful, while also restricting its power and potential misuse. Oils from traps in a bottle should always take time to apply properly. Typically, 5 to 10 minutes should be needed to ensure the oil is spread properly and set. This further reins in potential for people to misuse or attempt to make game-breaking scenarios. Triggering the traps is always from a creature stepping onto or disturbing the oil on the trap surface. Complex triggering is not something that's required for these and allows for plausible use by non-caster classes. Additionally, once set, the trap lasts for 24 hours or until triggered. The duration of the effect once triggered is based on the spell itself, but like mentioned, should be less than the length of the effect from the cast spell. How you handle trap detection is something that comes down to personal preference for the DM in many cases. Often you'll try to prevent your players from shouting, "I check for traps!" every time they enter a room. To combat this, we recommend using passive perception to detect any slick or discolored surface, or you can just follow the rules for detecting magic. The traps are magical in nature and would give off a magical aura appropriate to the spell they're based on. The traps can be dispelled magically, or the oil can set off remotely by disturbing it after it dries. By making traps more accessible to players, you allow them to broaden their playstyles and give them new creative options to experiment with. You might just get some fun new kinds of strategy out of your group. If you use these trap ideas in your game, let us know. We'd love to hear how your group used them. As always, happy DMing!